Hello students, and welcome to the quick solution of All India CAS Test Series JEE Advanced 2020 Test 2A Paper 2 Code GNH Physics. Let's move to question number 1. In question number 1, a particle of mass m1 collides with another stationary particle of mass m2. If collision is perfectly elastic, then choose the correct statements. So we know that the velocity of mass m1 after collision is m1 minus m2 into u1 divided by m1 plus m2 plus 2m2 u2 divided by m1 plus m2. So this is the velocity of first particle in case of elastic collision. So it is given in the question, u2 is 0, so this part is 0. So v1 is m1 minus m2 divided by m1 plus m2 into u1. Let's check the validity of options. In option A, m1 is less than m2, then maximum possible deviation of m1 can be pi. In option B, if m1 is equal to m2, velocity of particles get exchanged only in case of head-on collision. So in case of head-on collision, if m1 is equal to m2, then v1 comes out to be 0. And if I calculate v2, then it comes out to be u1. Because v2, velocity of second particle after collision, can be given by 2m1 u1 divided by m1 plus m2 plus m2 minus m1 divided by m1 plus m2 into u2. Since u2 is 0, so this part is 0. So if m1 is equal to m2, then it is equal to u1. So v2 is equal to u1. So option B is also correct. In option C, if collision is head-on, then deviation of m1 can be 0. So if m1 is greater than m2, then the direction of velocity of first particle is along same sense of motion. In that case, the deviation can be 0. So option C is also correct. Since option C is correct, so option D will be wrong. So the correct answer for question number 1 are option A, B and C. Let's move to question number 2. In question number 2, consider the shown arrangement. 3 point masses M, 2M and M are connected by ideal strings each of length L and are placed over a smooth horizontal XY plane. At t equal to 0, each mass is given velocity V0 as shown in figure. Choose the correct options. So at t equal to 0, if I see the system, the linear momentum of the system is 0. It means the momentum in X direction as well as in Y direction is 0. So at t equal to 0, the position of center of mass is this and it is at rest. So during the motion of the point masses, the center of mass will remain at rest. So after some time, let the point masses of the system comes in this situation, and at this moment, the velocity of these masses m are in this direction and they are equal because of the principle of conservation of linear momentum in x direction. So let they are moving with speed v. So at that moment, the velocity of 2m must be 0 because these two particles have velocity in x direction and y direction velocity of these two particles become 0. So the velocity of particle 2m in y direction must be equal to 0 in order to conserve the linear momentum in y direction. So option A is correct and C is wrong. Let's check the validity of option B and D. Since there is no external force acting on the system and point masses are kept on the smooth horizontal surface, so their kinetic energy will remain conserved. So I can write 2 times half m v0 square plus half into 2m into v0 square. This is the initial kinetic energy of system and that must be equal to the final kinetic energy of system, that is 2 times half mv square. So on solving this equation, the value of v comes out to be v0 into root 2. So this V is the velocity of point mass M. So option B is correct and D is wrong. So the correct answer for question number 2 are option A and B. Let's move to question number 3. In question number 3, from a uniform solid sphere of mass M and radius R, a spherical portion of radius R by 2 is removed as shown in figure. If V0 and E0 is the gravitational potential and gravitational field respectively at point O, that is center of solid sphere, then we have to find out the value of V0 and E0. So first of all, if I calculate the gravitational field intensity inside the cavity, then it comes out to be uniform and its value is given by E vector is equal to gm by r cube into r vector, where r vector can be written as r by 2 into minus I cap, if I consider this as my x direction. So this comes out to be gm by 2r square into minus I cap. So the magnitude of gravitational field intensity is gm by 2r square. So option D is correct and B is wrong. Now I have to calculate the gravitational potential at point O. So in order to calculate the gravitational potential at point O, let this mass is filled with the positive mass as well as with the same amount of negative mass. So if it is filled with the positive mass, then first of all I am calculating the gravitational potential due to the complete sphere at the center O. So that can be written as minus 3 by 2 gm by r. And now I have to write the gravitational potential at point O, that is on the surface of the negative mass. So that is equal to minus g. If I calculate the mass m dash, then it comes out to be m by 8. So g into m by 8 divided by r by 2. So if I solve this, it comes out to be minus 5 by 4 into gm by r. So option C is also correct. So the correct answer for question number 3 are option C and D. Let's move to question number 4. In question number 4, a solid cubical block of side length A and density rho is made to move with constant velocity V0 I cap over a rough horizontal surface. Coefficient of friction between block and ground is mu. The magnitude of longitudinal and shear stress S1 and S2 respectively at the transverse cross section parallel to YZ plane through center of cube is. So if I see the friction force acting on this segment, then friction force acting on this segment can be written as mu into M. So total mass is m, so I have to write the half mass, that is m by 2, so that can be written as rho into a cube by 2 into g. So this is the friction force experienced by this cross section. So now the longitudinal stress s1 can be written as f upon a square. So that is equal to mu rho a g by 2. So option A is correct and C is wrong. In order to calculate the shear stress, so the shear stress in this direction is 0 because the tangential force in this direction is 0. So the value of S2 is 0. So option B is also correct. So the correct answer for question number 4 are option A and B. Let's move to question number 5. In question number 5, if gravitational potential energy of a particle of mass 1 kg in a region is given as U is equal to V0 x square plus V0 x into y square, where V0 is positive constant and x, y are the position coordinates of the particle, then we have to check the validity of given statements. So the force acting on the particle can be given as minus du by dx I cap plus du by dy j cap. So if I take partial derivative of potential function, then it can be written as V0 into 2x plus V0 into y square I cap. If I take partial derivative with respect to y, then V0 into x into 2y j cap. So this is the value of force. So in first option, so in option A, particle is in equilibrium at origin. So if x equal to 0, y is equal to 0, then the value of F is also comes out to be 0. So option A is correct. In option B, when particle is placed on positive x axis, the net force on particle is along negative x direction. So when the particle is on the x axis, then y coordinate is 0. So if I substitute the value of y coordinate to be 0, then F vector comes out to be minus V0 into 2x I cap. Since V0 is a positive constant, so we can say that the force on the particle acts along the negative x direction. So option B is also correct. In option C, the gravitational force on the particle will be under root 5 times V0 at minus 1 comma 1. So if I substitute the value of x and y coordinate, then F vector comes out to be minus of, if x is equal to minus 1, then it comes out to be minus 2 and here it is 1. So minus V0 I cap, and from here it comes out to be minus 2V0 J cap. So if I take the magnitude, then magnitude comes out to be root 5 times V0. So option C is also correct. Particle is in equilibrium at x equal to 1. So if I substitute the value of x equal to 1, then net force does not comes out to be 0. So option D is wrong. So the correct answer for question number 5 are option A, B and C. Let's move to question number 6.